Okay, let's move on to the next case.
Okay, now we have a 45-year-old male brought to triage by his friend who states the patient injured his left shoulder while playing football. The patient has a gross deformity to his shoulder and he has neurovascular deficits to his left arm. He's unable to move his arm and is complaining of excruciating pain, 20 over 10, and he's diaphoretic. So what do you think is going on with this scenario?
I think he's a level 2. He's in severe pain or distress, and I can't really do anything with him in triage.
Good. There's probably another reason that you could make him a level 2.
Is it because of his neurovascular deficits?
Absolutely. Now, are all dislocated shoulders level 2?
Probably not. It probably depends on how they look, how severe their pain is.
Great. So what if he did look pretty good, wasn't in a lot of pain, and had good neurovascular status?
Well, he'll just need an x-ray, so a level 4?
Well, probably not. He is still going to require IV medications to relocate that shoulder, and he's still going to need x-rays. So at a minimum, dislocated shoulders are at least ESI level 3. And remember, conscious sedation as a procedure counts as 2 resources.